Today I am very happy here to give a keynote speech. My dear friend Lokamitra ji invited to me come here and joined with your important forum to discuss Indian Buddhism today to, from today to future. I think he has done very important role here to regain of Buddhism after great leader of you, Baba Sahib Ambedkar. And he has vision. There are so many Buddhist thoughts. Buddhism is very, very big complex. But he traced proper place. Like me. Yesterday when we were in the bus, he traced Swarna Prabhasa Sutra, one of the most important valuable sutra in Mahayana text. I always traced Nibbalakirti and also Mahaprajna Paramita. However, we are very like-minded. I think you are very tired now because, no? Indians are not tired, no? Sri Lankans are very lazy than Indians. Here, our friends, Dhamma friends here, Mangeshkar, he introduced me, and also Cho Hua, master of Chinese Buddhism. And my friend, my disciple also, Ven Ratana Thero, hi, Honorable Eugene, and Vietnam Nan Mani, and professors. Please, I am going to explain what is the Buddhism, how we can get Buddhism to, how we can implement Buddhism to modern world, which we are in a lot of crisis, a lot of problems. First of all, I draw your attention to basic Buddhist principles. What is the Buddha's life? The Buddha's life, it is atiswabhavika vivarana, over-exaggeration. The Buddhist life story always exaggerated, not like a human being, like a god. Is it? It is a famous story, is like a god. The Baba Sahib Ambedkar drew your attention in his great works in Buddha, Dhamma, and his teaching. What is the Buddha's real life of the Buddha's life? Giving attention previous Buddhist text, according to that, Buddha did his great renunciation. Why? Having seen some poor illness person and oldest man, like that, you know, Satara Peranamiti. According to the Baba Sahib Ambedkar explanation, he renunciated from the worldly life to forest life. The reason is finding a truth and also finding a solution for the mankind, all the human beings, not only human, all the beings who are suffering. At that time, contemporary society of Buddha, most of people are suffering from war, struggling each other. Monarchy system and also democratic system. Vaisali and Sakyas, they have separate identity. And so at that time, there was many tribal wars, most of kings, they attempted to expand their power to other small, acquiring small kingdoms. But it's a one. Second is, poor or rich, everyone suffering. There is the Siddhartha, Prince Siddhartha is a hierarchy monarchy prince. He lived under the very luxurious life. He realized this is the life. One time he lived with 500. 500, not 1, 2, 3, 500 women, according to the Pali text. Is there is happy? Thirsty, tired, all are combined together, related together. And finally he understood material life is not for happiness. Finally he went to forest to realize Dhamma. What is the truth? To achieve liberation from himself, to find real life of life, real spiritual life. But finally, what he understood, according to the Brahmajala Sutta, he mainly criticized Rishi tradition and Hermes tradition, who are forever in forest, practice rigorous practice, highest level of samadhi, very magical powers. Individually they achieve very magical energetic powers. He can do very magical things. There are so many gurus in India even today. They can do many magical powers, but people are suffering. India has lot of rishi, lot of gurus, lot of kindness people, lot of compassion. But what happened to the Indian people? That is the problem. That is why Buddha come out from the forest. That is traced by Baba Sahib Ambedkar. Lord Buddha practiced two things. When just he explained the truth, anyone can understand within one moment, who has capability, wisdom, energy, power. Many, many people, some are finding women, like first group of the monks, you know the first group of the monks. I don't like to go in detail because I don't have more time. I need more time to explain. However, I would like to summarize. Lord Buddha rejected magical power of samadhi. Self-satisfaction through spiritual achievements. Samadhi means there are so many samadhis. Unconscious level of mind, there is nothing. Sanya Veda, without sanya, no any consciousness. Anyone can live sometimes 100, 200, 300 years. He achieved such type of samadhi level. He understood this is not a real truth. It is not a solution for others. He come out from the forest and he rejected four samadhis. Only he always proposed in Theravada text, four samadhis. Are you agree with me? Four samadhis. Mainly Satipatthana Sutra, most famous spiritual book, it is focused on meditation. to develop mindfulness, inner peace, self-understanding. This sutra is very important sutra. I think this is the sutra to link all the Buddhist monks, Mahayana, Chinese Buddhist, or Sri Lankan, or Indian, whatever Buddhist. We can link to mindfulness practice. Everyone can accept. The Chan tradition or Zen tradition, whatever tradition, link with basic Pali Satipatthana Sutra. And then, what is the always Lokamitra tell? Triratna. What is the Triratna? Teacher, Dhamma, doctrine. Third, Sangha. Sangha. Why Buddha proposed Sangha? There is no Buddha now. There is no teacher. Now I am teacher. I transfer my knowledge, Buddha's knowledge, by my words in English language. So, when individually anyone realizes Dhamma, he can isolate himself. That's the point. Organization is very important. When I was university, I was Marxist. There are so many Trotsky groups. They proposed, do not organize party. Party is wrong method. And Leninist, Maoist, they proposed party is important. Organization is important. Without organization, there is no community. The name is community. Communist. What is the name of communist? Communist not created by Karl Marx. Not created by Mao. Not created by anyone. The early society of the humankind was pre-communist society, tribal society. According to the Atanita Sutta, there are so many tribes, they don't have private house, they don't have land, they no need to cultivate anything because everything is in nature. Nache bijam pavapanti napaniyanti nangala. There is no pulp, but they eat from the nature. That is a tribal life. Tribal life is community-based lifestyle. Buddha regained that tribal life again. Not only grasping with one particular tribe, but it is all the mankind who divided various nations, various tribes, bring to one with by using the doctrine of doctrine. What is the doctrine? Lot of people explain that. Many philosophical words, many things. Lord Buddha explained Dhamma. Dhamma is nature. Anicca. Why Buddha emphasized anicca? It is clearly, you highly attention, it is in vipassana level. When you awaken your mindfulness, you give attention, vipassana. What is the meaning of vipassana? Changing, process. There is no me. Every moment changing. My desires changing. My physical body also changing. Outer world also changing. Understanding that I come out from my egocentric attitude. I can destroy myself. There is no me, realizing the nature. Lord Buddha proposed, everyone proposed, if anyone want to see the world, you see the Brahman, you see the God. Lord Buddha explained that, you see yourself. Vyamatte kalebare meva dukkhancha dukkha samudayancha dukkha nirodhancha dukkha nirodhagamini patipadancha panyapin. Anyone can see the truth is within body, dukkha, suffering within body, liberation in your body. of liberation in your body, not outside. Lord Buddha always emphasized interconnection. My Mitra, Loka Mitraji explained that interconnection is very important word. Very important word. What is the interconnection? We always divided, good or bad, beautiful or ugly. This food is very taste. I drink now some of tea. I like to drink, but it is not taste. Okay. Whatever, when I get it, I have motivation through my organs, sexuality or my tongue, my eye contact, everything. Attraction to something. Lord Buddha asked, what is the attraction? You see your tanha. You see, what is the tanha? Tanha means pleasure, nandi. Raga means attachment, memorize in your mind. Whatever things you experience, you keep it in mind. Lord Buddha finally explained that this normal behavior of the mind created egocentric grasping that called upadana. Upadana means you expand your world. This is my land. This is my center. This is my sect. This is my country. Like that. This is my big house. Is mine. I have a lot of children. I have a lot of, like, lot of students also. I have big monastery, big students, big numbers. I enjoy myself. Oh, I am a number one teacher in the world. It's also egocentric attitude. Whatever the Buddhist teaching was for some of grasping. Just to realize the Buddhism, you give up that. The Buddhism is the word. Now I transfer the words. Word is not truth. You have to overcome the truth. We need more time to discuss that. But however, I want to summarize this, my Buddhist explanation, Buddhist teachings explanation. Or when anyone who understands Buddhism, he come out from his egocentric attitude. Very simple. I be a part of the nature. Wherever people are crying, I am with them, I also cry. I feel that because my mind is full of kindness. Anyone who understands the doctrine, he open to the world. Nature and me combine together. Ajjatta bahidhava kaye kayanupasi viharati. I live with the nature. There is no division. Bahidha and me, you and me, you and me. There is no division, high caste or low caste. That is the realization. Very simple. We have very thirsty, very big motivation in our inside. This is like a devil. Very dangerous. All the powerful people created, businessman or like a Hitler or whatever, great things, all are created by their egocentric energy. Dharma is also saying, but later converted. The Lord Buddha proposed how we come out from the personal egocentric attitude. There are two types of grasping, material things and also ideological things. Some are grasping Allah, it's the highest grasping. They sacrifice their life for Allah, not for the people, not for the nature. Suicide. It is a drushti, a dikti gahana, andhakarani. When you grasp in something, you blind completely, you blind, totally you blind. You can't see the nature. Then I give you attention next paragraph. How we can implement this type of teaching to modern world? That is my argument. I explain my experience. I am a Buddhist monk. When anyone who enlightens himself, I always think very openly. I don't have any hesitation with others. strategically, I think, how we can collaborate, how we can build up good solidarity, everyone. Come out from all the barriers, overcoming the barriers, how we can bring together, how we can build up good solidarity. Now, Lord, the Nagar, his center is Nagarjuna. Nagarjuna explained that Sammuti Manasritya Paramatana Deshati. Lord Buddha in the Pali text, it is available in Pali text. Sammuti Goharati Na Aparamasati. Within awareness of worldly life, we can't teach spiritual life. Some rishis, some Buddhist monks explained that, I am meditating in the whole highest level of bhavana like that, I am vipassana very good. I am arahatta like very slow, everything is okay. But they don't. Every Buddhist monk, every Buddhist followers need world conditions. Without understanding our nature, nature is part of me. We can understand, we can change the world. Then I explained my simple experience in Sri Lanka. I understood that there is a monopoly. All the mankind now in grip. How we can come out from this grip? How we can get liberation? One example. I think number one is there are so many numbers, but I give one example. Agriculture. It is very easy to understand. You ask why Ratana Thero explained agriculture. So what is the problem of Dalit in ancient time? The land. The person who has capacity, but they don't have land. They are laborers. The Lord Buddha explained, some scholars, some religious, spiritual leaders explained that Buddha explained only Satipatthana. It is wrong. Lord Buddha explained how originate poverty. According to the Kutadanta and Chakravati Sihanara Sutta, Yog Sahanti Kasi Gorakke, Tesang Bijabattam Anupadetu Maharaja. Who has capacity to cultivate? You give lands. Because at the Lord Buddha's time, according to this sutra, there are so many poverty. People are struggling. First time, the king gave more money for the fighters. Give, you go, eat, and happy. Don't steal anything. He told to others, I try to steal something. King gave me this one. Others also tried. Then finally, king decided to punish everyone who trying to steal something. Then after people organize as a force, it called in Pali, Dasu Kila, Dasu. The word is very important. Dasu word. Dasu mean workers, slavers. They organize as a very unique power. Finally, the king couldn't control. The other Brahmanas, great Brahmanas, great teachers, advice, give puja for the Brahma and others. The one of intelligent Brahmin teacher, he advised this way. What is this way? There is a poverty. Why poverty? They don't have land. Land is number one for the farmers. We have to fight for land. Sri Lankan people also don't have, under the colonial period, all the lands acquired the British. It gave to the Iraqi people only. But a lot of radical people fought against the government. We get now Sri Lanka, the farming areas, every farmer has 1 or 2 acres. It is not a solution. One occasion, I worshipped to the Ruan Valley, a very famous pagoda, biggest pagoda in Sri Lanka, 2000 years old. One occasion, early in the morning, I worship, I chant Karani Mitta Sutta, and I walk on the bounds of the paddy fields. There is a footpath, bounds of the paddy fields. Then I see one of the farmers spraying chemicals. thousand and thousand insect, frogs, many, many insects try to live, condemned to death, spraying the many, many chemicals. Then I understood that what is the Buddhism? All the Buddhist followers tell that, you also tell that, Panatipata Veramani Sikkhapadam Samadhiya. Every innocent farmers, they get the spray machine, spray poison in the soil. Uncountable beings are dying, destroyed. Now it is 2030, WHO announced very big report in Sri Lankan diseases, especially non-communicable diseases, kidney. At that time, 2013, there were 25,000 kidney diseases affected people. 25,000, land is our, but people are suffering. Gujarat also same, because they use highest level of chemicals for cultivation, carrot, beet, guava, whatever. Finally, WHO clearly mentioned that glyphosate is the main effect of kidney diseases. But not directly, but indirectly, they explained that. Finally, I discussed with the president, former president. Finally, we couldn't do anything because Monsanto is biggest company in the world. We couldn't do anything. Finally, after coming new government, I prohibited Monsanto's glyphosate. Only two countries prohibited, El Salvador and Sri Lanka. Now it's Assam in India. Only Assam. This is very poisoning glyphosate. They changed the variety of the seeds under the Green Revolution. All the seeds which we use in our fatty fields, controlled by chemicals and fatty seeds are combined together. I experienced with the farmers last 3 years. What is my experience? Without chemicals, without any chemical companies, we can cultivate. That is my experience. Some Chinese, some Korean scholars, they are very good scientists. They invented many things for organic agriculture. Finally, I implemented. I can very competitive with chemical agriculture. Without chemical agriculture, we can get enough income, very economical, compared with chemical agriculture. That is my experience in Sri Lanka. When anyone who want to build up a Buddhist life, way of life, we have to challenge the unethical chemical agriculture. It is mafia. All the entire world, Philippines or Sri Lanka, India or China, wherever, all the entire world completely dominated by those multinational few companies, all the agriculture sector, everywhere in India. Illegally come from Tamil Nadu, Sri Lanka. When we ban, illegally come to Sri Lanka. There is a big story I like to discuss with you. I proposed my friend Lokamitaji, all the activists who are Buddhist involved with you, please teach them to practice organic agriculture. That is the revolution we need for modern world. Because all the you know that in America, Los Angeles, 1,000 court cases filed by the victimized people who victimized by cancer against the Monsanto company. 1 month ago, CNN announced that judgment. I have judgment in my phone. 1,000 people, they 2-3 thousand million dollars. How to be paid by the company for farmer. So Monsanto is glyphosate is in India, very big issue. Bangladesh also same, Nepal also very same. As a Buddhist, non-harming, non-poisoning agriculture system we have to introduce. And second one, this we have to, I explained that Vyavahara manasitya paramatta deshate. Spiritual gaining is not private one. It is not in the shrine room. It is not in the jungle. I come out from my egocentric attitude. I think about people, why people are suffering. And other in the world, the America is the number one country in the world economically. But their health condition is not number one. They are 40 like that. Because of obesity, cancer, blood pressure, many, many diseases, non-communicable diseases. So, this civilization, this new era started from industrial revolution. At the beginning of 20th century, we have great hopes. Lot of scientists invented many things. Oh, coal and fossil fuel is the magical power in the world. People are very happy. Every fans, everything's cooling systems, everything, all the machine factories run by the fossil fuel or coal. All the trains, all the aeroplane, everything. But what happened when we have to face two wars? As a Buddhist followers, we have to think. Within 2 years, killed 10 million people in the world. You can believe that. Why? Why? What is the mind of the man? You have to think. You have to watch. It can be happening again and again. Then I don't like to explain in detail, but I want to emphasize one thing. Fossil fuel and coal is not a energy for world. Because this is now very clearly shown, big disaster in the world. Now world carbon emission already over. Should have to be only 3.5 tons. Now it is gone to the over 4.5. 20 years ago, under the UN resolution, they explained that we should be maintain our global warming minimum one Celsius. Now already gone 1.5 over. Now tsunami conditions, disasters, flooding. Kerala is flooding. Sri Lanka is a beautiful country, you know. 2 years no rain for the farmers. Why? Climate change everywhere happening now. The greedy people decided their policies for coal and fossil fuel. Uncountable bloodshed happened in Middle East even today. 62 countries now, even now, having the war. Syria, Egypt, Libya. Why there are wars? The reason is energy. Fighting for energy. Now it is going to end. Now scientists invented so many renewable energies. Here is Mihai. He is scientist. And he know in detail. You can discuss with him. Now solar is cheaper than coal, but monopolize solar business. In Sri Lanka, you know that we have sunrise. This is our time. 12 hours we have sunrise. We can implement solar. Every poor houses. All the nations who are 12 hours sunrise, we are poor. Don't have sunrise properly. They are rich. 4/3 of the world income is fossil fuel. That is the reason. That is the facts in the world. Now the time, coal and solar, after 50 years after, no solar, no coal. No Middle East. One example, Arabi. There is 7 lakhs only people, they are inhabitants. But there are people 6 million. Most of them are Indians and Pakistanis and Bengalis. 6 million people in Arabia. Why? It's a desert. Oil. Big market created by oil. We have to understand these figures. Now the time awaken again. Who are with nature? We have nature. India have nature. Good nature. The Buddhism come with nature. This is the time. We have time to renewable. We have to convert the world for renewable energy immediately. We challenge the authorized countries, please be reduce your carbon emission. India. They are thinking. Their carbon emission low, 2 tons low. Sri Lanka is 1 tons low. America is over 14, over 16. China over 6. This is now the time, toxin-free world. No carbon emission. This is the challenge of Buddhism. With spirituality, we fight for this world. Humanistic, with social justice, society. Because anyone who chant, Sabbe Sattha Bhavantu Sukhitattha, may all beings be happy. How I tell? Any farmer can tell them? Maitri Bhavana can't do this agriculture system. Changing this agriculture system, we can't practice Buddhism. When I eat the food, I am vegetarian. One fisherman eat for 1 kilo for fish, but farmer kill 10 over kilos beans for one production, 1 kilo production. When I eat something, whatever, Dole banana, Dole company banana introduced by them. So, I draw your attention, this is a time for sustainable era. The protection of environment, it is Buddhist viewpoint. The nature is part of our life. To protect our mother earth, we tell that in the South Asian people always tell that not fatherland. We tell Mata, Mikata, motherland. We are the beings, we are inhabitants of our mother earth. Our Mata, our mother is our earth. All the planetary people who think like us, we solidarity to under the one flag. I believe Buddhist spiritual people can play big role in this context. That is my speech. Thank you very much for your time.